Today we celebrate the solemnity of Mary, St. Mary of the Cross, MacKillop. We ask through intercession for good health for our country and for all its citizens and for all the good work that through her God has brought into this country, and the grace for all people to come to love God and to make God loved in this world. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit to be with you all.
Your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, source of all goodness, who have shown us in Saint Mary a woman of faith living by the power of the cross, teach us, we pray, by her example, to live the gospel in changing times and to respect and defend the human dignity of all in our land. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the union of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. And then the word of the Lord came to Elijah. Up and go to Zarephath, a Sidonian town, and stay there. I have ordered a widow there to give you food. So he went off to Sidon. And when he reached the city gate, there was a widow gathering sticks. Addressing her, he said, "Please bring a little water in a vessel for me to drink." She was setting off to bring it when he called after her. "Please," he said, "bring me a scrap of bread in your hand." "As the Lord your God lives," she replied, "I have no baked bread, but only a handful of meal in a jar and a little oil in a jug. I am just gathering a stick or two to go and prepare this for myself and my son to eat, and then we shall die." But Elijah said to her, "Do not be afraid. Go and do as you have said. But first make a little scorn of it for me and bring it to me, and then make some for yourself and for your son. For thus the Lord speaks, the God of Israel, jar of meal shall not be spent, jug of oil shall not be emptied, before the day when the Lord sends rain on the face of the earth." The woman went and did as Elijah told her, and they ate the food, she, himself, and her son. The jar of meal was not spent, nor the jug of oil emptied, just as the Lord had foretold through Elijah. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul clings to you, your right hand holds me fast.
My soul clings to you, your right hand holds me fast.
O God, you are my God, for you I long, for you my soul is thirsting. My body pines for you like a dry, weary land without water. So I gaze on you in the sanctuary to see your strength and your glory. My soul clings to you, your right hand holds me fast. For your love is better than life, my lips will speak your praise. So I will bless you all my life, in your name I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled as with a banquet, my mouth shall praise you with joy.
My soul clings to you, your right hand holds me fast.
On my bed I remember you, on you I muse through the night, for you have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice, my soul clings to you, your right hand holds me fast. My soul clings to you, your right hand holds me fast.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. As the chosen of God, the holy people whom he loves, you are to be clothed in heartfelt compassion, in generosity and humility, gentleness and patience. Bear with one another. Forgive each other if one of you has a complaint against another. The Lord has forgiven you, now you must do the same. Over all these clothes, put on love, the perfect bond, and may the peace of Christ reign in your hearts, because it is for this that you were called together in one body. Always be thankful. Let the word of Christ, in all its richness, find a home in you. Teach each other and advise each other in all wisdom. With gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms and hymns and inspired songs to God. And whatever you say or do, let it be in the name of the Lord Jesus, in thanksgiving to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us stand to welcome the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. Many women were there by the cross, watching from a distance. The same women who had followed Jesus and looked after him. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
I'm telling you not to worry about your life and what you are to eat, nor about your body and how you are to clothe it. Surely life means more than food, and the body more than clothing. Look at the birds in the sky. They do not sow or reap or gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not worth much more than they are? Can any of you, for all his worrying, add one single cubit to his span of life? And why worry about clothing? Think of the flowers growing in the fields. They never have to work or spin. Yet I assure you that not even Solomon in all his regalia was robed like one of these. Now that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is there today and thrown in the furnace tomorrow. Will he not much more look after you, you people of little faith? So do not worry, do not say, what are we to eat? What are we to drink? How are we to be clothed? It is the pagans who set their hearts on all these things. Your heavenly Father knows you need them all. Set your hearts on his kingdom first and his righteousness, and all these other things will be given you as well. So don't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the gospel today, we hear our Lord saying, I'm telling you not to worry about your life. That wasn't quite so straightforward for the woman in Zarephath, nor for the woman who we are celebrating this morning, St. Mary Magdalene. The woman from the Sidonian town, who we heard from in the first reading from the Book of Kings, was crushed with worries and anxieties, who labors under a death sentence. She says, I have no baked bread, only a handful of meal, and I've gathered a stick or two and will prepare this for myself and my son to eat, and then we shall die. The worries and anxieties of a mother, worrying for her child and preparing the Last Supper for both of them. And within this context, then we see Elijah, whom God commands to go to Zarephath, where a widow will feed him. Upon his arrival, Elijah discovers that the widow is the unlikely source of hospitality, because he encounters a woman who's preparing her Last Supper and he sees, well, there's not many food here. In fact, it is in this place, in the midst of this contradiction, that God will have an opportunity to act. Elijah blesses this woman, letting her know that the jar of meal will not be spent and the oil in the jug will not be over. And they both eat and are blessed through the providential care of God. Mary MacKillop, for whom this reading has been chosen to remember at this Mass, would have understood the plight of this woman. She would have understood the widow's anxiety and her worries, because Mary MacKillop had plenty to worry about, and she had a heap of anxieties to deal with, not least of which was fighting the bishops. She struggled within her congregation, her estrangement with Father Julian Tennyson Woods, with whom she worked so closely. And then she had endless problems with her own health. And yet the extraordinary thing, and surely one of the greatest signs of her sanctity, was that none of this crushed her. Beyond all the worries, beyond all the anxieties, she was and remains a woman who was and is unfailingly thankful to God, who constantly provided for her needs. All her worries and anxieties, which should have destroyed her and certainly destroyed her work, in fact had the opposite effect. That's why she stands forever as Mary of the cross of the Lord Jesus Christ. At every Mass, where we participate in the sacrifice of Calvary, after the Our Father and prior to Holy Communion, we ask the Lord at every Mass to deliver us from all anxiety. Our prayer indicates the belief that someone can do something about our anxiety, about our worries, and that someone, of course, is the Lord. It is with this Lord and Savior that Mary MacKillop had a beautiful relationship. In the midst of all her struggles, of all her worries and anxieties, she knew that the Lord would provide for her. And there are times she couldn't understand why things were happening, but she simply realized that it was joy to see the will of God unfold in her life. While she couldn't understand and she suffered from it and with it, it was God's will that she ultimately sought each day in her life. In every Mass, for example, we ask God to deliver us from all our anxieties. It's another way of asking God to increase our faith in Him. The opposite of anxiety is serenity, a sense of peacefulness. We have this beautiful image that we have acquired recently in the parish hall here of St. Anthony's of Mary MacKillop. You look at her face, her eyes are so powerful, so intense. You can see suffering in there. There's also a sense of calm, of serenity. With serenity, our lives are amazing, regardless of our external circumstances. The beauty of serenity is found in the Serenity Prayer. Though many people know the first part of the Serenity Prayer, most do not know the whole thing. And I would like to use this prayer to finish my homily today. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference, living one day at a time, enjoying one moment at a time, accepting hardships as the pathway to peace, taking as He did the sinful world as it is, not as I would have it, trusting that He will make all things right if I surrender to His will. that I may be reasonably happy in this life and supremely happy with him forever in heaven. People of faith, let us stand now to profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified upon Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord,
the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We are about to offer and receive Christ our Lord, the living bread, which comes down from heaven. As the Father draws us to his Son, let us pray with concern for the needs of others.
That the Eucharistic Church may express its communion with Christ by a constant ministry and charity, constant ministry of charity and mercy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the Father may draw all the nations to the eternal reign of his Son, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have been affected by the COVID-19 virus, may God grant them health, strength to those who care for them, comfort to families, and salvation to all victims who have died. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We ask that our faith and hope be fired afresh by the Holy Spirit, that like Mary MacKillop, we may live with courage, trust, and openness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray especially today for all of the Josephite sisters, for all the work they have done over the years. We pray especially also for their associates. We pray that the Lord will continue to send his Holy Spirit among them to continue the work of Mary MacKillop in our time. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are sick and frail, especially those who asked for our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died recently, especially Cecilia, who passed away today, and for those whose anniversaries occurred this time, especially Michael Turkson, and for all the Josephite sisters, and for all their associates, that they may enjoy eternal rest, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father, we believe in you and in your Son, our Eucharist. Grant the petitions of this community through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As you gather us, O God, at your holy altar on the feast of Saint Mary of the Cross, grant, we pray through our intercession, that what we offer with praise and petition may strengthen us all in charity and faith, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits you crown your own gifts. By their way of life you offer us an example, by communion with them you give us companionship, by their intercession sure support, that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors the race before us, and win with them the imperishable crown of glory, through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels, and the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, his assistant bishops, and all those who are holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, especially all our parishioners at St. Anthony's and St. Bernard's, and for all those who are participating in this Mass from home. And all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we your servants and your holy people offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings, a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, for all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, and those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some shared fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours for ever and ever.
Amen.
The Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we are always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I invite you to make your spiritual communion the prayers now placed before you. Let us pray. May the sacrament we receive, Lord God, on this feast of Saint Mary, strengthen us to walk the way of the cross and bring us the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Through the example of Saint Mary of the cross, may you learn to recognize God's will for you and trust in his providence.
Amen.
May her life of service awaken in you a deep respect for the poor and a strong will for justice.
Amen.
May you share in her courage, see with eyes of Christian love, and learn from her holy deeds.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
I wish you all a very happy feast day.
Thank you, Father.